Dr. M.C. Sundaraja. He completed his undergraduate studies from Madurai Kamaraj University and went on to complete his master's in structural engineering from the same. He is a doctorate from Anna University and he's also done his postdoctoral fellowship at the Queensland University of Technology, Australia. He has more than 17 years of experience in the teaching profession and he has also published papers in 39 international journals, 7 national journals, 27 international conferences and 51 national conferences. He has so far published 124 papers in various journals. He went on to receive the Best Research Paper Award from IFERP, a unit of VVERT and NIAR on 4th April 2015. He has also received Outstanding Faculty Award from the Venus International Foundation Faculty Award, VIFFA, in the year 2015. Currently, Dr. M.C. Sundaraja is now working as an assistant professor in Thyagarajar College of Engineering, Madurai.
Welcome to UGC lecture series in bioarchitecture. In the previous lecture, we have seen how to calculate the load acting on the beam for the design of continuous beam. And we have also found the bending moment at various locations using IS caudal coefficients. Now, in this lecture, we are going to find out the AST required for each and every moment which has been calculated using the moment coefficient which is as per IS caudal provisions. And finally, then we are going to check the deflection of the beam, that is the depth of the beam against deflection, and also we are going to draw the reinforcement detailing. This is the table 12 which is given in IS 456-2000 to find out the moment at various places for the bend, for the continuous beam. But in the case of continuous beam, based on the deflection nature of the beam, the moment has to be found at the respective places. Before that, first we have to see how the beam which is deflected, based on the deflection nature of the beam, the moment has to be analyzed and it has to be found. Now, this is the beam which is subjected to uniformly distributed load. Here the span of beam is L. Now, due to the load, the beam will be deflected like this. This is the deflection nature of the beam, and using this deflection nature, this beam has to be analyzed by means of a proper analysis, that is by means of a classical method of analysis, that is slope deflection method, moment distribution method, or any Karnis method or the matrix method. But here, in order to avoid those difficulties by analyzing this this continuous beam using those methods, the IS caudal has given the moment coefficient to find out the moment at various places of the continuous beam with the certain conditions. That is, the first condition is the beam has minimum of 3 or more spans and the load must be uniform throughout the entire length of the beam, and also the span must be uniform. And if the span is different, the span should not vary the 15% of the largest one. Along with this conditions, the moment coefficients has to be used. When you start using the moment coefficient to find out the bending moment in the case of this beam at various locations, the moment distribution need not be carried out. This is as per IS 456-2000. And these are all the moment coefficients at various places. So, in the case of continuous beam, in the previous lecture, we have calculated the load, that is live load as well as dead load separately, since the moment coefficients for the continuous beam at various locations for dead load and live load has given separately. And also we have found the bending moment, that is the bending moment near the middle of end span, that is total bending moment near the middle of end span is WD L square by 12 plus WL L square by 10, since the dead load moment coefficients is 1 by 12 and live load moment coefficients is 1 by 12. So, the total bending moment is a sum of the bending moment due to dead load as well as live load. So, this moment coefficient has to be again multiplied by the total design load WL and the effective span to get the bending moment. In similar manner, the bending moment has to be also found at various other places. Now, we have started doing some problem to design the continuous beam. That is, span of beam is 4 meter and the WL which is given in the problem is 25 kilonewton per meter and the material which has given in the problem is M20 and Fe415. So, before designing, first the steps to design the size as well as the area of reinforcement is the load calculations. Since the moment coefficients for dead load and live load has given separately in the case of IS code, the dead load and live load has also been calculated separately. The dead load consists of, as I have already explained you, the dead load consists of self weight of the beam itself and any other load which is fixed with the beam. Now, here we have assumed the size of beam to find out the self weight. That is, we have started assuming the size of beam as 230 by 450, but this assumption has to be again based on the deflection criteria. For for continuous beam, the span to effective depth ratio from the deflection criteria is 26. So, from this I have assumed that d is equal to 4000 by 26. So, based on that my experience, I have started assuming the beam as 230 by m 450 mm. Since the reason of RCC structure is a trial and error method. So, I have started assuming the size of beam as 230 by 450 mm overall. So, from that I have found the self weight of the beam is 230 by, that is 0.23 by 0.45 and 25 is equal to 2.59 kilonewton per meter and the live load given in the problem is 25 kilonewton per meter, that is denoted by WL. Then using the moment coefficients, I have started calculating the moments at various places. First one is a span moment, that is moment in between the support is called as a span moment. There are two spans, one is end span, other one is the other interior spans. The end span at the edge of the beam is called as the end span, that is, and the intermediate beams are called as the interior beams. Normally, in the case of mid span, that is the end, the span, the moment which is found at the middle of the span, that is why we have found the moment at the middle of end span is 1 by 12 WD L square plus 1 by 10 WL L square. Then I have substituted dead load and the span and live load and the span, I have calculated the moment at the middle of end span is 43.45. In similar manner, I have also found the bending moment at the middle of interior span, that is 1 by 16 WD L square plus 1 by 12 WL L square. Then the moment I have obtained here at the middle of interior span is 35.92. In similar manner, I am also going to find out the moment at the supports. There are two supports, that is a support next to the end support and the other interior support. There are one more support, that is end support. The end support which is normally assumed it is a freely supported. If the wall is considered going to be, which is wall is constructed above the support, the beam is assumed to be built into the support. So, it has certain fixity which is developed at the support. So, there is a partial fixity which is developed at the support. So, the moment has which is developed near the support, that is W L square by 24. This is as per IS 456-2000, but this is a very minimum bending moment in compared to other bending moment. That is why they ask us to provide the 50% of the reinforcement which is provided near the middle of end span has to be provided at the top at the support, and that is at the end support to resist the deflection of the beam over the support. Now, here the moment at the support next to the end supports are 1 by 10 WD L square, 1 by 9 WL L square. So, here since in the minus sign indicates it is a negative bending moment, it is a hogging bending moment which is the beam which deflect upwards, that is why it has been indicated by negative sign. So, the moment at the support next to the end moment is calculated as 48.58 kilo Newton meter. Next, the moment at other interior support minus 1 by 12 WD L square minus 1 by 9 WL L square, then I get substituted load and the span, then I get obtained the moment at other interior support is 47.89. So, normally in the case of among 4 moments, the moment at the support next to the M moment is normally greater than the other moments, but in the case of continuous beam, the beam has, the depth of the beam has to be designed against the maximum bending moment which is developed in the beam. But in the case of finding or determining the area of reinforcement, the area of reinforcement has to be separately found for all other, all firm bending moments. To find the effective depth of the beam, I have selected the maximum bending moment. Then to find the effective depth of the beam, we are normally equating the maximum bending moment to the limiting value of the bending moment. The limiting value of the bending moment for the given grade of steel is 0.138 fck bd square. Then I am going to equate the mu max to the mu limit, then I am finding the depth of the beam. Here the maximum bending moment is 48.58, that has been again multiplied by the factor of safety, we get the bending, that is ultimate maximum bending moment as 72.87. Now it has been equated to the mu limit, then d is equal to mu square root of mu maximum divided by 0.138 fck b. So here I have assumed b as 230 millimeter. By substituting b here, I have got the depth of the beam is 338.80 m. Now this is the effective depth. Normally effective depth is the distance between topmost extreme fiber to the center of the tension reinforcement, that is 338.80 m I have obtained. Then from that I have found the overall depth of the beam as 338.80 plus clear cover plus diameter of the rod by 2, that is 378.80, which is compared to the assumed value of the overall depth of the beam, that is 450 m. Now this depth is again very less than 450 m. So the assumed depth of the beam is more safe against flexure. Now this depth of the beam has to be again checked against the limit state of serviceability, that is the deflection criteria, that will be checked at the end of the beam. So for that I am keeping overall depth of the beam as 450 m, and small d is again 450 minus 30 minus the diameter of the rod by 2. I am assuming the diameter of the rod is 20 m, so it is 410 m. Now I am going to start finding the area of reinforcement required for all the bending moments, that is the bending moment at the various places. So first bending moment AST required for the moment near the middle of N span. So to find out the area of reinforcement from the bending moment, I am choosing the equation mu equal to 0.87 Fi AST into d minus 0.416 xu. This is the equation. Since I have provided here the depth of the beam is much greater than the depth required from the bending moment. So it becomes automatically, it becomes a singly reinforced rectangular beam or under reinforced rectangular beam. That is why I have used this as the equation to find out the area of reinforcement for all the bending moment. So here the first bending moment is mu, here it is 43.45 into 1.5, that is equal to 65.175 kilo Newton meter. So and xu, here it is 0.87 Fi AST divided by 0.36 fck b, that is 0.87 into 415 into AST divided by 0.36 into 20 into the assumed width of beam is 230 m, which will be arrived as 0.218 AST. Now I am going to substitute the expression, that is 65.175 into 10 to the power 6 is equal to 0.87 into 415 into AST into D is 410 minus 0.416 into 0.218 XU. So from that I have obtained a quadratic equation AST squared minus 4521.40 AST plus 1.99 into 10 to the power 6 is equal to 0. So by solving this quadratic equation, we are going to get two roots. From that, we need to select the minimum road since the beam is designed as under reinforced or singly reinforced beam. So, here from this, I have found AST required is 494.13 millimeter square. I am providing 16 mm diameter bar. From that, I am finding the number of bars equal to, that is 494.13 divided by pi by 4 into 16 square. I am getting, that is 2 point something, I am getting it as 3 numbers. So, provide 3 numbers of 16 mm diameter bar for resisting the bending moment near the middle of end span. Next, AST required for the moment at middle of other interior span. So, here the bending moment is mu is equal to 1.5 into 35.92, which is equal to 53.88 kilo Newton meter. So, here by using the equation, that is mu equal to 0.87 Fi AST into d minus 0.416 XU. So, here we have already found XU is equal to 0.218 AST. By substituting mu and the XU value, that is 53.88 into 10 to the power 6 is equal to 0.87 into 415 into AST into D is 410 minus 0.416 into 0.218 AST. So, from this I have obtained an quadratic equation, that is AST squared minus 4521.40 AST plus 1.65 into 10 to the power 6 equal to 0. So, from this by solving that equation, I have obtained the AST required as 400.39 millimeter square. So, from this I am using 16 mm diameter bar. Number of bars required for this AST is 2 numbers of 16 mm diameter bar. Next, AST, in similar manner we are going to find out the AST required for resisting the bending moment at the support next to end support. Here the moment we have found is 48.58, 1.5 into 48.58 to get the ultimate moment, that is equal to 72.87 kilo Newton meter. Now, by using the above equation, mu equal to 0.87 Fi AST into d minus 0.416 XU, where XU we have found as 0.218 AST, and by substituting the bending moment 72.87 into 10 to the power 6 equal to 0.87 into 415 into AST into 410 minus 0.416 into 0.218 AST. So, AST required for resisting the bending moment at the support next to the end moment is 563.42 millimeter square. So, here by using 16 mm diameter, the number of bars needed at the support next to the end support is 3 numbers of 16 mm diameter bar. Next, the AST required for resisting the moment at other interior supports. So, the moment we have found as 47.89, 1.5 into 47.89 89, that is equal to 71.84 kilonewton meter. Again, by using the expression for singly reinforced section, mu equal to 0.87 FY AST into D minus 0.416 XU. From this, XU was found as 0.218 AST. By substituting the moment and the XU in the expression, 71.84 into 10 to the power 6 is equal to 0.87 into 415 into AST into the D is 410 minus 0.416 XU. So, from this I could obtain a quadratic equation AST square minus 4521.40 AST plus 2.19 into 10 to the power 6 is equal to 0. From this, I have found AST is 351.68 millimeter square. Again, here I am using 16 mm diameter bar. Number of bars needed to resist this bending moment is 3 numbers of 16 mm diameter bar. This is the way of finding the area of reinforcement required for resisting the 4 bending moment at the respective places. So, now before seeing the arrangement or detailing of reinforcement at the various places, now we need to check the depth of the beam against the limit state of serviceability, that is the deflection. So, here in the case of the maximum bending moment, AST required is 563.4 millimeter square. We have provided 3 numbers of 16 mm diameter bar. The AST required for the maximum bending moment is, AST provided for the maximum bending moment is 603.19 millimeter square. Now, here we are checking the depth of beam against deflection. So, the L by D ratio for the continuous beam is 26, and depending upon the type and area stress in the reinforcement, this factor again modified by multiplying with the modification factor, that is MF. This MF has to be found from the graph which is given in the figure 4 of IS 456-2000, that is the figure shows the modification factor versus percentage tension reinforcement. So, for finding the modification factor, to find modification factor, first we need to find out the percentage of tension reinforcement, 100 AST provided divided by B into D, that is 100 into 603.19 divided by 230 into 410, that is equal to 224.83 Newton per millimeter square. Then we need to find out the stress in steel. Stress in steel is 0.58 Fi AST required divided by AST provided. This is a formula which is given in the figure 4 of IS 456-2000. Now, I am substituting the parameters 0.58415 into AST required for this case is, that is the maximum bending moment is 563.42 and AST provided is 603.19, that is equal to 224.83 Newton per millimeter square. This percentage of steel is, we have worked as, that is 0.64%. Now, the from the deflection criteria, that is L by D ratio is equal to 26 into modification factor. So, D we required here, it is L by 26 into the modification factor. The L for the beam here, it is, the span of beam is 4 meter, that is 4000 millimeter divided by 26 into the modification factor is. So, from these two criteria, and the modification factor was found from the figure 4 of the IS 456-2000 is 1.2 into 1.2, which is equal to 128.21 millimeter, which is very less than 410 millimeter. So, hence it is safe against deflection. But for moment, the depth required is 378.80 millimeter, but the provided depth is 410 mm. For the deflection criteria, the depth needed is 128.21 millimeter, and we have provided is 410 millimeter. So, from these two things, the critical point of critical one is the moment. So, the for the moment it needs 378.80, but we have provided is 410. So, this is most safe as well as I think that it is most economical section. Now, in addition to this longitudinal reinforcement, the beam has to be the beam should also be designed with the shear reinforcement. Now, the shear design of shear reinforcement is not in the syllabus of the B architecture. Now, we need to see the detailing of reinforcement. So, here we have the four span continuous beam. So, the moment near the middle of end span is 3 numbers of 16 mm diameter bar. It needs, so here it is 3 numbers of 16 mm diameter bar, and moment at other interior span is 2 numbers of 16 mm diameter bar. So, here it is 3 numbers, here it is 3 numbers, at the middle of other interior span it needs 2 numbers of 16, and for the support next to the end support it needs 3 numbers of 16 mm diameter. It has been provided for a distance of 0.3 L on either side of the face of the beam. Here also it has to be provided, that is 0.3 L, and the remaining beam, that is the remaining reinforcement, must be extended throughout the entire length of the beam to provide or to hold the shear reinforcement is 2 numbers of 16 mm. And other interior support also we have found the minimum reinforcement required for it is 3 numbers, that is here it is 0.3 L, we have provided 0.3 L, and the two reinforcements must be extended throughout the entire length of the beam to hold the shear reinforcement. This is the arrangement of reinforcement required for the continuous beam. Now, we come to the summary of this lecture. In this lecture, we have found the reinforcement required for the continuous beam at various places, and also we have seen the depth of the beam against deflection, and also we have seen the reinforcement detailing of this continuous beam, which has to be provided at various places. This is as per IS 456-2000. And in connection with this lecture, the question may be also be asked, that is, design the beam and the area of reinforcement required for 5 span continuous beam of effective span 5 meter subjected to total live load of 23 kilonewton per meter. Use M25 and Fe4500 as materials. So, from this also we have to find out the live load and dead load separately, and using moment coefficients we need to find out the moment at various places, and for the maximum bending moment we need to find out the depth of the beam, and that is depth of the beam again it has to be checked against the deflection by finding the area of reinforcement at 4 places. And in the case of continuous beam, the detailing of reinforcement is most important, how it has to be provided by referring the IS 456-2000. In connection with this lecture, the references needed are IS 456-2000, Plain and Reinforced Concrete Code of Practice, and another book which is written by S. N. Sinha, that is Reinforced Concrete Design. Thank you very much.